Hey guys, it's Appleman. Welcome back again to my channel. So for today's video, I wanted to do a little bit of a Appleman hot take, if you will, my two cents on the topic of art style, style theft, all of that in general. This is something that a lot of people talk about and wonder about, and I just want to give my opinion on the matter. But before we get into that, I'd like to thank today's video sponsor, QV. QV is a brand new game in which you embark on a journey with QB to explore ancient ruins, challenge puzzles made by ancestors, and find out how to keep the universe from falling apart. I just want to say real quick that I absolutely love the art style in this game. It's super adorable. In the game, you use QB's brush to create an ink bridge over the water and draw portals for interdimensional travel. It's a game for everyone, both beginners and challenge lovers, and it supports a total of 7 languages. As you go along on your adventure, you'll meet new companions such as Farron the Penguin, as well as discover hidden fairies within stages that will allow you to unlock costumes and hairstyles. The game has controller support and is currently available on the Nintendo Switch and is releasing on Steam on March 18th. So you can use the link in my description below to travel to the game's Steam page and save it to your wishlist. So thank you again to QV for sponsoring today's video. And real quick, I just want to let you guys know that there's actually a giveaway going on. There will be 4 winners in total. First and second place prize will get a $50 Amazon gift card, as well as a Steam key for the game and a Steam key for the original soundtrack. Third place will get a Steam key for the game as well as the soundtrack. And fourth place will get a Steam key for the game. So that is a pretty awesome giveaway. All the information about that will be in my description below, so definitely check that out. So before I begin talking about today's video topic, I want to just talk to you a little bit about what you're seeing on screen, the artwork. So this is a drawing of one of my OCs, my character's Rin, and you might recognize her from a previous video that I did where I drew a glitter demon is what I called it. And I took that and I wanted to make that into a character of mine. And so I kind of changed her up a little bit, her design, into something that I like. And I absolutely love her and I'm obsessed with drawing her all the time and actually have some brand new enamel pins of a few of my characters, Doe, Mepeat, and Rin as well. So if you're interested in those just came out on my store this week. They're brand new and I absolutely love them. I would do anything for my characters. So check those out if you're interested. I'll have a link below. Anyway, for this artwork, I really wanted to draw her in a very chill setting. Just watching TV, I call this piece browsing, and right now she's technically not browsing the channels because she's not holding a remote, but I do change her pose later on in the video to be holding a remote, so the title is justified. She is browsing. But I mostly wanted to do this piece because I wanted to practice some lighting. So I wanted to draw her in a dark room and just practice how the lighting from both behind her with the lamp and in front of her with the TV would affect her and the environment around her. So I'm still learning, but this was a really fun piece to practice with and I really love the way that it turned out. So I hope you enjoy watching it in the background. Anyway, like I said, I wanted to talk a little bit about art style for today's video. And you might remember that I think about 2 years ago now, I had a video where I talked about 5 tips on how to find your art style. And that video did pretty well. I think you guys liked hearing me ramble on about art style and tips like that. And so for today's video, I wanted to talk about art style, but not any tips on how to find one. But instead, my opinion, my hot take, if you will, on art style as a whole, art style theft, things like that, because some people love to be foaming at the mouth, literally, over this topic, and I don't really understand why. Anyway, I'll start off by asking the question, what is an art style? And the way that I define an art style is how an artist draws, you know, the style that they draw in, but I think it goes a little bit further than just how somebody draws eyes or how somebody draws hair. I think it also extends to how they do the line art, how their brush strokes look, maybe the line weight and the thicknesses, how they like to color. Like, for example, if I look at the artist Yoai Hime's art, I know it's hers, not only by the way she draws the characters, but when I see that perfectly colored line art that matches all of the colors in her art piece, I just know it's hers. And that's the thing, with art style, usually you can look at a person's artwork and you just know it's theirs. Anyway, a lot of people like to talk about art style theft. And I think that this is a touchy subject. I think it can be a gray area at times, because I don't necessarily think you can steal an art style, but at the same time, I understand the frustrations of somebody copying an art style. So I will talk a little bit about what I mean by that. When people typically talk about art style theft, they'll say that, oh, you know, so-and-so is copying this other person's art style. They're drawing just like them. And that can be frustrating, I'm not gonna lie. I've seen that happen with many artists before, but I also wanna make the point that I don't think it's necessarily possible to really steal somebody's art style, because unless that person is legitimately studying every single piece of art that one person does and copying the way they do something in every art piece and really like studying what they do, I think it's very difficult to exactly copy an art style. And at that point, it seems like a lot of effort, honestly, to do all that. Because as artists, we're constantly being inspired and constantly learning from other people. And so if you ask an artist who's been doing art for 20 years, what inspires them? How did they come up with their style? They're probably going to name a bunch of artists that inspire them, and they're gonna name a bunch of things that they like to draw and then talk about how it morphed over time. If I had to guess, that's at least what I would say. As artists, since we're always being inspired, I think it's very difficult for people to be completely original. And so where our originality comes from is how our own brains like to look at things and like to do things. So for me personally, I love drawing girls with big eyes and really like, I don't know, cute facial features. And I like to go all out on that kind of thing. And I'm still figuring out where I want to be with my art style, but I think it's constantly changing and evolving. And typically when you find your art style, you can take different factors you like about different people's artwork. Maybe you like the way that this person does their proportions, but you like the way this other person does the eyelashes, and you like the way this other person does the coloring inside the eye. And then you kind of find something that makes you comfortable, but you know, it's a combination of a bunch of ideas rather than copying. I also just want to note that I did look into it, and apparently you cannot copyright an art style or trademark it. However, you can copyright the final piece or the finished work, because that is yours. But when it comes to the actual style or the process or the method of drawing, that part itself cannot be copyrighted. So by definition, nobody can own an art style. Now, in terms of copying, I've definitely seen a few artists. For example, I saw this one artist on DeviantArt back in the day. I don't remember the name of the artist or the artist that I thought they were, but when I saw their artwork, I legitimately thought it was this other artist that I followed, but it was under a different name. And then I went and looked at the gallery and I realized, oh wait, this is a completely different person. This isn't them. But when I saw the artwork, it looked almost exactly like it. You could always tell though that it was a little different, but you knew who they were trying to be like. So that's frustrating, but I don't really think that anybody can do anything about that really. I don't think you can really claim, okay, they stole my art style. If anything, imitation is the biggest form of flattery. If somebody wants to draw like that, what's really to stop them from drawing like that? It's not like, I don't know. That's why I say it's a gray area, because I personally, while I find it frustrating, I don't necessarily think that you can really do anything about it or should do anything about it. I mean, you can always talk to somebody if it's really obvious that they're just copying every piece of artwork you do. For example, tracing your artwork or, you know, heavily referencing your art pieces. I think that is crossing the line. But when somebody's taking inspiration and trying to draw like you, I find that even if it looks like your art in the moment, I think their art's going to evolve past that, because everybody's art changes. So I don't really think that you can really steal an art style, because I feel like art style comes from your brain. It comes from your mind. And while you can learn to draw in other styles, I don't know if it'll necessarily be yours unless it's coming from what you want to be doing. So that's my two cents on this whole topic. I think that it's kind of a gray area. While I think that you can't really steal art styles, I also think that it can be frustrating to deal with people who are copying you. So that's how I feel about this whole topic. Anyway, Before I close out the video, I want to say a congratulations to our Discord art contest winners for the month of February. This month's theme was diversity, and I want to thank everybody who joined and congratulate the winners again. And if you're interested in joining any of our art competitions, we hold them every month, and I'll have the link to my art server in the description box below so you can join if you're interested. Also, be sure to check out the links from our sponsors, as well as all of my links in the description box below, the link to my online store, link to my Patreon pin club, my Discord server, as I said, and my Instagram page. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed it as always, and I also hope that you have a wonderful, beautiful weekend. I'll see you all in my next video. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.